Good morning or good afternoon, depending on where you are, and welcome to our conversation on RAN optimization. This is part of a report that Centipede has prepared with RCR Wireless, and today we're talking to Vicent Soler at the CTO office in Spain at Astellia. And he has been working for a long time on RAN optimization in Astellia, and we will talk to him about what is that they do there. Vicent, thanks for taking the time to talk to us today.
Thanks to you.
So to get started, can you give us an introduction as to what you're doing at Astellia?
Okay, so Astellia is a leading provider of network and subscriber intelligence, enabling mobile operators to drive customer experience and business performance. So our solution is a real-time monitoring solution that provides different use cases for different departments, and it covers end-to-end most of the other technologies, 2G, 3G, and 4G, from both radio to core network.
So what are the major pain points that at the operators that you're trying to address? Because there's so much optimization that you can do. What specifically are you focusing on?
Well, in RAN optimization, there are different pillars. For instance, one of them is troubleshooting. So once you have a customer complaint or you have an issue in the network when your KPIs are not correct, then you need to understand what's happening. So we have one solution dedicated to troubleshooting that allows you to drill down from the KPI into the CDRs and also to the messages. We have also a solution to monitor the KPIs, as I said before, end-to-end, from both radio to core network. And then based on that, it allows us to get KPIs not only for the network owners of the network, but also for customers, for handsets, and so on. Also, something very important in RAN optimization, as you can imagine, is automation. So our solution is thought to automate as much optimization tasks as possible, typical cases like ANR, PSC, PCI, and so on. And finally, the last pillar of our solution is also the geolocation. So geolocation enables a lot of use cases, and some of them are dedicated to RAN optimization, but some others are used by different departments like marketing.
Mm-hmm. Yes, and I think that a lot of the RAN optimization has been traditionally not in an automated fashion. So there was a lot of manual intervention, this seems to be changing. Why is it so?
Yeah, actually, our company was one of the leaders at the beginning. We started with this solution based on traces. And it replaces partially the drive test, as you said before. In the past, in the legacy solutions, operators were using vans and engineers to go to measure to specific places where they had issues. And right now, the concept is much different. Right now, the idea is just to use all the subscribers that we have in the network as drive testers, but allow us to have much more details than before. In that situation, in that case, of course, automation and being able to process all the data is critical, and our solution is able to provide this kind of processing and also to provide the right recommendations to improve the level.
Yeah. Now, one thing that when you're trying to optimize, you start typically with a problem. And the problem, increasingly it's with the subscribers. Subscribers, the quality of experience is not good and you have to address it. But if, for instance, somebody doesn't have, video doesn't work very well on their phone, how do we know? Isn't it difficult to understand where is the problem? Because it could be in the RAN, it could be in the core, it could be in the handset. You know, how do you figure that out?
Well, at the end, you need, to parse. Of course, you need the proper solutions, the proper software, in order to understand what's happening in the network. As I said before, in our portfolio, we have a solution that is able to provide performance analytics from different point of view, not only from the cell point of view, but also from the subscriber point of view, from the handset point of view. And then that solution allows us to, first of all, to have a clear idea about what's happening in the KPI. So you see that one KPI in one area is degraded. You want to understand if it is due to one customer, to one handset, to one parameter, and so on. based on that, it helped us to put a focus on some specific scenarios. And with the troubleshooting capabilities, we can drill down to understand what's happening from the signaling point of view. Keep in mind that also this is the case where you don't have, I mean, where you have to understand what's happening. But by default, you need solutions that automate the typical tasks that you have to do in the network. I mean, the network is alive, it's changing every minute, and you have you need the means to keep the network under control. So all these things that are basic automation tasks that require a lot of time are covered by our automation solution. Just to for instance, to be sure that the parameters are the right parameters, and the parameters are in the range that you expect, because at the end, it's a parameter of the network has to be defined by operators, but your engineering rules are accomplished according to your definition. And if you have these basic tasks, you have this automation under control, if you have the capability to monitor the KPIs and to understand what's happening from different point of view, I say not only from the cell point of view, from other point of view, and finally you have the capability to drill down to specific issues, you have your network optimized.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and this is, as I said, it's complex because the same type of problem from the end user point of view might be due to different type of problems sources. So you might need to look at different KPIs and interpret different KPIs in different ways. So there is a lot of data that is involved there. How can you, and you know, sometimes when you talk to operators, they're a little bit wary of, you know, they don't want to get too much complexity in their optimization. How can you avoid that?
Well, basically, as I said before, first of all, you need the right products, and Astellia can provide that products. And also, if the operators feel that they don't have enough capacity to manage the situation or to fix the issues that they are facing, we can help them a lot because we have a strong CNS department, consultancy and services department, with a lot of expertise on this area. And combining both product and services, we are sure that we can fix any issue that you can have in there. And I think that this is something very important for our company because, as I said before, our main objective is just to provide the right answers to operators. And with this combination, you can be sure that this can be fixed.
Mm-hmm. Now, you mentioned geolocation before, and obviously mobile operators know where their subscribers are, otherwise they'd be able to deliver their calls. How do you use that information to optimize the RAN or to understand what was wrong? And how can you do so without getting completely flooded with all the details of where everybody is and keeping track of them?
Well, there are different use cases with geolocation. So at the end, geolocation, what you do is for each individual call, you geolocate where the call is in at any moment. And based on that, you can plot or you can have maps with a lot of indicators. For instance, something very useful for operators is to understand where they have the black spots in terms of quality. So if we are able to geolocate, for instance, the areas with higher number of drop calls, then the engineer can put a focus on that area. Sometimes when you see the KPI, the cell KPI, you realize, okay, my drop call is increasing, but this cell can be covering 2, 3 kilometers, 4 kilometers. So with each geolocation solution, you just put the focus on the right, in the right area. This is one use case. Another use case is that when you have a customer complaint and you have an issue in the network, if you don't have the geolocation capability, then you need to reproduce this issue. You probably don't know where the issue is happened to that specific subscriber. So if you have this geolocation capability for each individual call, when you have a troubleshooting issue, of course, you can understand what's happening and where it was happening. And there are more use cases, for instance, when you have massive maps of coverage. So since you have all the users of the network are becoming drive tester, and you have the position, you can have massive maps of coverage, of quality. And therefore, for instance, you can plan where you're going to deploy new sites in the future. And this is something very, very, very useful for operators. And then there are more other use cases not related to RAN optimization, but for marketing and so on. And finally, one of the use cases that right now is becoming more relevant for operators is the small cell planning. So right now, operators are looking for solutions to offload the traffic from the macro cells And having this information to know where the users are located, to know where they have good or bad quality and so on, is very useful to define properly the right position to deploy a new small cell.
So basically you help the operator within the macro area, where is that they should put the small cells, where is it they need capacity? That's right. Yeah.
And then our algorithm is able to combine different magnitudes, because in some cases you want to reduce the traffic of the macro, in some other cases you want to improve the quality of the subscribers and so on. Mm-hmm. So the algorithm that we have is able to combine different indicators to provide the right answer to our customers.
Yeah, and that is really crucial, because the error finding for small cells can be quite complicated, especially if you don't know where the subscribers are, and then you end up putting small cells in the wrong place. And that brings the whole issue of optimizing the RAN in sort of in the present, given the infrastructure you have, but also to with a view on the long term. So what that brings is it's planning. It's an impact on planning and also on CapEx, I would imagine, because that means that they don't have to deploy capacity that where they don't need it or when they don't need it, right?
Yes.
How do you do that? How do you have operators managing that specifically?
Well, reducing CapEx can be done in multiple ways. Of course, for instance, when you optimize the network at the end, you're getting the maximum benefit from the existing network. So at the end, you can reduce CapEx, for instance, when you reduce congestion. So you have less congestion in one area because you optimize, for instance, the tilt, or you add a new carrier, or you define engineering rules to move traffic between different carriers and so on. When you have this situation, of course, you are saving licenses and so on. Also, when you have to deploy a new site, as I said before, knowing the right position of the site that you have to deploy is critical, because maybe you can maximize the traffic capture depending on the area that you have. And also, of course, you can also reduce the number of node bees, the number of licenses. For instance, something that we also do is the estimation of the CPU consumption of the network elements. And based on that, we can even reduce the CPU consumption, just changing some parameters in the network that allow us to save CPU in some network elements just by reducing the signaling. So at the end, optimization means CapEx reduction and also OpEx reduction, of course.
Yeah, absolutely. That is quite important, especially as we move to more small cells, more network complexity. And now that brings also another issue of looking at the performance and optimizing performance in a situation where you have a headnet, where you have multiple layers that are, interacting with each other. So you introduce another layer of complexity there. How can operator deal with that?
Well, when you deploy new carriers, for instance, to specific sites, you have to review the parameterization of that site. So in our case, the solution that we have is able to cope with very complex engineering rules to ensure that the traffic is moving between all the carriers as it was defined. In some cases, we have seen situations where the operators were deploying new carriers, and the carriers were not gathering any traffic, just they were not used. And it was basically due to issues with the parameterization. So in that case, it's clear that one, you have to deploy new carriers and new sites and so on, you have to be sure that the network is under control. And not only that, of course, you deploy new cards and new sites, you want to be sure that the sales and the site are properly optimized as soon as possible. And again, we come back to what I said before. Automation again is one of the key tasks here, because it allows you to be sure that all the configuration of all the sales in the sites is properly defined.
Right. And how does it relate to Sun? Because also Sun is trying to optimize RAN performance. But how does your solution relate to that?
Well, our solution is able to work in both in open loop and closed loop. Basically, Sun, the definition of Sun is just to automate those tasks that take a lot of time to engineers but are easily automated. So in this, for instance, in under Sun, there are different use cases. One of them, of course, is INR, the network definitions. And in our solution, we can automatically, the solution defines the right recommendations for different use cases and so on, and it automatically delivers the recommendations to the OSS. If the operator wants to do that, if the operator wants to review the recommendation before the recommendation is sent to the OSS, the operator is able to see in our solution what is which are the recommendations provided by the tool. Mm-hmm. So basically, SON is one of the basics tasks in run optimization, and our solution is able to cope with that.
Yeah. So basically, an operator can have SON, and that's useful because the two work together. But they don't have to have SON in order to use your solution. So the two are independent.
That's right. Yeah. I mean, for instance, when you have a customer complaint and you need to understand what's happening, in that case, SON probably is not useful. So in that case, you need the monitoring solution and also the capability to drill down into the messages. But in other situations, what you need is just to be sure that the network is under control, and then SON is giving you this capability. So on a daily, in run optimization daily jobs, you need to have all these capabilities to be able to understand what's happening, because some cases it can be an issue with one customer, with a handset, some other cases can be an issue with neighbors, in some others it can be a parameter. So I think that at the end, you need, in run optimization solutions, you need to cover all these things, all these different pillars, geolocation, mm-hmm. so on, monitoring, automation, and so on.
Yeah, and another dimension here is voice. And especially with voice over LTE, there is a lot of sort of growing problems. There's a lot of not just optimization, but understand how it's working. How can you help operators with that?
Well, in the case of Astellia, you know, Volte is running in the user plane, and in the case of Astellia, we have our own props. Our props are one of the best in the market, and we have the capability to monitor all the SIP signaling in the user plane. And not only that, especially in the case of 4G, our pros work in the core network, but also we have the capability to monitor the RAN interface. So as I said at the beginning, at the introduction of the company, one of the key differentiators that we have as a company is the capability to provide an end-to-end vision. So we're able to combine both the user plane analysis for Volte and the core network, and also the RAN interface. And then we have, in our solution, we have lots of dashboards providing lots of indications for Volte.
Mm-hmm. Right, and this is very important, especially for applications like Volte, because you, from a RAN point of view, it might look like the traffic is just flowing perfectly well, but then there might be the problem might be somewhere else. So you need to have the end-to-end solution. I guess it's
yeah, that's right.
For both data and voice applications, right?
And user plane and control plane, that's very important in this case. Because in the case of 4G, in some cases, when you want to monitor the Volte from the OSS point of view, you can lack some details about the performance of voice, because you can only get indicators about the QCI and so on. So I think it's very important to have this capability, the capability to monitor both user plane, control plane, and in radio and core network parts.
Mm-hmm. Right, and now another further complication here is the introduction of Wi-Fi calling. So we have Volte, then over the top voice, Wi-Fi calling. So and each one of them has its own different issues. Can you help operators with that as well?
Yeah, Astellia has also the capability to monitor the Wi-Fi networks. Mm-hmm. So we have props in the IMS, and we did with that. With that solution, we're able to understand if the usage is in Wi-Fi, if it is in the mobile network and so on, and then we can track the user, we can provide all the signaling messages and so on, again, from the end-to-end point of view. So, yes, we cover that that capability, and it's part of our existing portfolio. Mm-hmm.
So, and this is quite important, because for cellular operators clearly have much better view in under on the performance and on the network, but for Wi-Fi, they might not have control over the access points, or they might not have any visibility in the network, but they still need to know what the performance is so they can make their own decisions, right? So you're able to provide information on whether the same analysis, whether it's Wi-Fi or 3G.
Yeah, the analysis is the same. It's the same for voice Wi-Fi, mm-hmm. voice over Wi-Fi, and voice over LTE. So we have the IMS solution being able to monitor this all the interfaces related to voice for both technologies, and then you have the same indicators. In the case of LTE, you have the CS4 dashboards, you have the RSIR BCC dashboard. So I mean, we have all this information is provided in our solutions, and we have all the dashboards that operators need to be sure that this new technology is under control.
Right. Now, in another dimension, you know, it seems like optimizing the RAN is becoming more and more complex issues. There are many more elements that are relevant, and one is virtualization. As the network become virtualized, it's very important to have an end-to-end solution, but to find out where in the end-to-end continuum there is the problem is coming, the problem is coming from, or where you can optimize it, becomes even more complex, isn't it?
Yeah, and in the case of, in the case of SDN and FB, again, Astellia has a solution that is able to work in these scenarios. Our solution is based on OpenStack. Also, we can even feed the NFB orchestrator to have the information that the orchestrator needs to define the new network elements in the network. So, yes, you're right. Here again, the RAN optimization can become more and more difficult.
Mm-hmm. Right. So, from when you talk, I'm sure you talk to many operators, and you know, you see what is that they're struggling with right now. What would you say that they are the major challenges that they are facing now, and are they look to tackle in the near future?
Well, one of the things that, I mean, what we see everywhere is that, well, as you said before, now you have 2G, 3G, 4G, now LTE is coming, Wi-Fi is coming, so it's clear that right now the technology has evolved so fast that operators and everybody has difficulties to be updated with the latest technology, so that's clear. In this scenario, parameterization and having the right knowledge about how to get the maximum from the network elements is critical. And again, parameterization, for instance, is quite difficult. Automation is something that the tools provide, so this is something that probably for operators is not so relevant. But and finally, another situation that we have faced is that in some cases they have lack of experts and lack of people, because the networks are bigger and bigger, and they don't have enough hands to manage everything properly. So in this situation again, so Astellia can be a right partner, because we can provide the solution and also the people that can help operators to manage the situation. So these are more or less the thing that we are facing everywhere. And of course, customer experience, being sure to deliver the right quality to the customers is critical. So maximizing the IRPU and so on. This is, of course, one of the challenges that operators are facing right now. Mm-hmm. And that we see everywhere.
Yeah, everywhere. So there's not much difference in terms of geography. It's pretty much the same problems all over. In closing, can you tell us what is that you're working on right now, and what is that you see that is going to become a hot topic over the next few years?
Well, we keep working with automation, of course. For us, it's important. Customer analytics is also something that is becoming more and more relevant. And then big data, yes, here, because right now there is so much information in the network that can be used for purposes, that big data is a technology that is becoming very important, and our company again is well positioned to have the answer in big data. So we use big data as a technology for our solutions, but also we can fit big data platforms to provide the right data that I need from the RAN point of view. As I said before, SDN and FB is coming, Wi-Fi, we have now IoT and 3G. In LoRa, IoT, 3GPP, geolocation is also improving because of the MDT and so on. So all these technologies are part of our portfolio, and we are working on them. We are evolving the solutions to cover most of the needs that operators can have.
Yeah, actually, IoT is going to be an interesting case because the network is the same, but the requirements for the services are different. So
it's much different.
Yeah, you need to develop new tools, so it's basically the same tools that you just take into account the different requirements of the different services.
Well, it depends on the data that you can monitor. It depends on the sensors that you can have. I mean, in this situation, we are not talking about people; we talk more about machines. But at the end, the technology is almost the same. So you have an interface. You send some information, and then with this information, you store this data in big databases, in big data, and so on, and you process it to provide the right use cases. And of course, 5G is coming, and our company is also entering into this new world. And well, I'm sure that in the following months, in the following years, we will see a lot of changes in the market again because of this 5G interruption.
That's right. 5G is coming. Well, listen, thank you so much for sharing your insights with us today.
It was a pleasure. Thanks to you.
So this conversation today was part of a report around optimization that Sensafili and RCR Wireless worked on together, and that is available for download. Thank you very much for attending, and listen to the other presentations as well.